Once again, we're back again watching another video that's gonna get me in the mood for Valentine's Day. I have not watched this movie in I don't know how many years, but funny story is that I used to watch this movie on repeat with my mom back in the day. She and I were big Jane Austen fans. I've watched most of the Jane Austen films that have come out, the different iterations, the different variations of this story. I am so excited to be revisiting this one today. This is the 2005 Pride and Prejudice movie starring Keira Knightley. I am so excited to be re-watching this, and if you know, you know. So let's see what I miss. Let's see about the story. I hope you guys are excited because I sure as heck am. But before we hop into it, make sure that you guys subscribe and hit that like button. Don't forget to follow me at the two social medias, Twitter, Instagram, Bo Fun Times. Also, don't forget to check out my Twitch at twitch.tv/moviesindepth, where we stream every single time a new video goes live at 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Also, don't forget to check out my Discord community. You can come chat with me and the rest of the Movies in Depth family. Also, don't forget to check out my Patreon at patreon.com/moviesindepth for the full uncut length reaction to this and all other movies and TV shows covered on the channel as well. And let's just get right into this. Focus features really did say, hold my beer for this one. It also doesn't help that I'm a sucker for classical music, so you throw classical music into one of the greatest classical stories of all time and I'm going to be a mess. One word, just one word, Queen. Oh, Papa. Yes, they seem to have let the cows run in the street again. You see those ducks? They weren't even looking at him and they're like, oh my God, you have to keep throwing food on top of our heads? We're full.
Do you not want to know who has taken it?
As you wish to tell me, my dear.
This is how I know this actor. The most of you all know him from The Hunger Games. This is where he really took his roots. Donald Sutherland, I think that's his name.
Single.
And
Mr. Bingley,
Mr. Bingley, who has 5,000 a year.
Once.
Good heavens. People.
Me.
You must, Papa. At once.
There's no need. I already have.
Have?
When? I'm sorry. Would you like me to drop the mic on your face?
Have you no compassion for my poor nerves?
They've been my constant companions these 20 years.
Why is he me?
So will he come to the ball tomorrow, Papa?
I believe so.
That'd be me. I'd just be sitting there watching them like, yes, fight for it. Is it just me, or every single time you watch this movie with Keira Knightley and this music, you just want to watch Pirates of the Caribbean 2? Am I the only one?
Love every man in the room does not end the evening in love with you, that I am no judge of beauty.
All men.
There actually happens to be a few women as well.
Someone will catch your eye, and then you'll have to watch your tongue.
Just as long as they don't have a name with the letter D, I will be fine. Everybody has a poop, but that's what we invited you.
It's miserable, poor sir.
Miserable it may be. But
if I hear one comment about me resembling the redhead on the right, then we are going to fight. Hey, bro, do you think this guy knows how to smile? Or do you think that his jaw is kind of locked that way?
The Darcy of Pemberley and Derbyshire.
How do you do there, sir, you little pompous?
The regiment are coming!
I never get that. Why would you be happy that officers are coming? I get that you're saying you want them to be able to marry your daughters, but you're basically saying, oh yes, please marry my daughter and then go off to war and get killed.
Will you dance, Mr. Darcy?
Not if I can help it.
Fair enough.
We are a long way from Grosvenor Square, are we not, Mr. Darcy?
We only have enough room for one sass bucket in this movie, sweetie. Pass it over.
Fairly tolerable, I dare say. Not handsome enough to tempt me.
Handsome? I am beautiful, sir! This movie and this story does such a good job of just subtly showing you and telling you things just by eye contact and where they're looking.
It is a pity she's not more handsome.
Mama!
Do you know that we're in public? How much wine have you had?
So what do you recommend to encourage affection?
Dancing.
Yeah. You kind of stepped into that one, didn't you? I just wish that they could have played some hip-hop music as she was walking away right there.
At first I said that I love you and you ain't say that shit back.
Easily forgive his vanity had he not wounded mine. But no matter, I doubt we shall ever speak again.
Boy, are you in for a ride.
When you die, Mr. Bennet, which may in fact be very soon.
The hell you just say?
A letter addressed to Miss Bennet, ma'am, from Netherfield Hall.
We are safe, Nick.
I think their mother is the definition of shrewdless.
She'll go on horseback.
Horseback?
In the rain. How petty are you, Mama?
Now she'll have to stay the night, exactly as I predicted.
You sly little devil.
Though I don't think, Mama, you can reasonably take credit for making it rain.
Ah, it was a 50-50 shot.
People do not die of cold.
I'm sure the same people said that about the plague.
Good Lord, Miss Elizabeth, did you walk here?
I did.
Thank you for that kind observation, you little twat.
Thank you.
You know how they say you can cut the tension with a knife? Well, with that one, it is a butcher block!
She looked positively medieval.
My goodness, did you see your attitude? It's actually found in the pot. Correct me if I'm wrong, but are officers even paid that well? Or are they just coasting by? They didn't stop their whole formation just to hand me my handkerchief.
How many letters you must have occasion to write, Mr. Darcy?
I forgot what the relationship is here, but I do remember that she is a complete.
I'm no longer surprised at your knowing only 6 accomplished women. I rather want to know you're knowing any.
It would certainly be a fearsome thing to behold.
I see what you did there.
Mr. Darcy is not to be teased.
Are you too proud, Mr. Darcy?
No, I'm actually just a very poor sport.
Maybe it's that I find it hard to forgive the follies and vices of others. My good opinion, once lost, is lost forever.
So you're more of a half-glass full sort of guy, or what are we working with here?
What a shame, for I dearly love to laugh.
First dancing, and then laughter. Is there anything else of the joys of the world that you want to try to take away, Mr. Darcy?
Excellent room you have, sir.
The 3 on the left, and then the 1 on the right. I can't.
I think a ball is a perfectly irrational way to gain new acquaintance.
Do you see what dress you're wearing? Do you want to input over here? Ah, I still get goosebumps at that part in every single person's pants, and I mean every single person's pants, collectively went at that moment.
His name is Mr. Collins. He's the dreaded cousin.
Who's to inherit?
Mr. Collins just sounds like a frumpy name. You know?
Mr. Collins.
Speaking of Pirates of Caribbean crossover.
How happy for you, Mr. Collins, to possess the talent for flattering with such delicacy.
Their dad is me!
And though I do sometimes amuse myself with arranging such little elegant compliments.
Just had a little bit of a... potatoes!
Which speak very eloquently on all matters moral.
They're all saying, Elizabeth, if you laugh, I swear to God, I'm going to lose it.
But Miss Lizzie, next to her in both age and beauty, would make anyone an excellent partner.
Yeah, except for the fact that she is an absolute firecracker and will blow this whole to kingdom come.
Mr. Wickham's a lieutenant.
An enchanted lieutenant.
I'm sorry, Will Turner knockoff, what are you trying to say over here?
Don't blame Turner. He was merely the tool of your betrayal.
Elizabeth, did we need to talk about where your eyes just were right there? I know you're enjoying the officer, but good Lord, you enjoying his packages too?
Of course you must come, Mr. Wickham. If you'll excuse me, lady.
I have a sourpuss to deal with because apparently you've pissed him off.
How cruel.
So now I'm a poor foot soldier, too lowly even to be noticed.
Wait till you'll see the whole picture though. Always gotta see the whole picture.
Oh, breathe in.
I am breathing in. You're trying to suck my ribs out.
If it is not true, let Mr. Darcy contradict it himself. He does. I hope never to encounter him.
But to be fair, he doesn't even know that you know. So how would he be able to defend himself?
I'm so pleased you're here.
So am I.
I've forgotten. Is Mrs. Bingley here, redhead girl? Is she trying to go after Darcy as well? I can't remember if she was or was not.
Best for her family.
You play a horror music right there, and that turns this movie into a completely different thing.
Be here.
There you are.
Of all the people I don't want to see.
Perhaps you will do me the honor, Miss Elizabeth.
Get a better haircut, and then we'll talk. She's like, if he looks me in the eye one more time, I'm not going to be able to hold back this laugh.
To me, but it does afford the opportunity to lavish.
You know, the one time I don't think it would be a good idea to have a conversation is when you're literally rotating partners on a dance floor.
It is my intention to remain close to you throughout the evening.
You're kind of messing up the dance here, bruh.
May I have the next dance, Miss Elizabeth?
Yes.
It would be most inconvenient since I've sworn to loathe him for all eternity.
You put yourself in quite a pickle.
I love this dance.
Indeed, most invigorating.
Wait, you just said that you didn't like to dance, so how would you love a dance?
I'm perfectly happy to oblige. Please advise me of what you would like most to hear.
Reply will do for present.
You know what this all boils down to? These are the two most collectively stubborn people of all eternity.
You talk as a rule while dancing?
No, I prefer to be unsociable and taciturn.
Not trying to point any fingers or anything.
Mr. Wickham is blessed with such happy manners.
He's been so unfortunate as to lose your friendship.
Is it getting hot in here, or is this just the movie?
I hope to afford you more clarity in the future.
You say what? That's so ingenious. Right there, that's when they just take away the rest of the room and it's just them dancing. That's all you need to focus on. Ah, the filmmaking.
Is that Mr. Darcy at Pemberley in Derbyshire?
Yes, it was. Now, do you want to actually try to talk to him?
Mr. Darcy?
He has a whole foot on you. I would pay just to have one person come in and be rude and go, you're and you are all
eat shit. Eat shit.
Eat
shit.
You eat shit.
Of course.
He does not know her character as we do. There is plenty of time for us to get to know them after we match.
That's the crazy thing about this time period is that they were so desperate on getting together and making sure these marriages happened that they don't even get to know the person. It's not even prearranged marriages. It's, oh, let's just get married and then see if we like each other.
I'm awfully sorry. Do forgive me.
I think her entire existence is just to get drunk and eat food. And honestly, that's a mood.
I've been practicing it all week.
And you still sound like oh, even now, that grosses me out.
That I might solicit a private audience with Miss Elizabeth in the course of the morning.
It's like that one time someone invites you to prom and you don't want to get invited to prom by them and you're like, actually, I'm busy. Wait, what about later? I'm busy then. What about later?
I'm busy always.
Can't even get your dad to stay? That sucks! It's so awkward.
Such an alliance will surely suit everyone.
Right.
Lady Catherine will thoroughly approve when I speak to her of your modesty.
I know we're in this century, bruh, but she's still gotta approve of it first. Consent still exists.
You could not make me happy, and I'm convinced I'm the last woman in the world who could make you happy.
She's gonna get it.
We'll have this little hiccup dealt with immediately.
Except she can outrun you tenfold.
What am I to do?
Well, come and talk to her. Now!
He's like, I am just trying to enjoy my morning coffee, and you just will not let me live in peace.
Your mother will never see you again if you do not marry Mr. Collins, and I will never see you again if you do.
Hey! That's the best papa out there! Let's go!
Ungrateful child! I shall never speak to you again!
Yeah, we don't really give a And the sister comes round again, conniving her little way through.
It's far more likely that he does not love me and never has.
He loves you, Jane. Do not give up.
You're just being timid. You know it's true that he loves you.
A girl likes to be crossed in love now and then. It gives her something to think of.
The father is literally one of my favorite characters in this entire movie. Can you imagine how sick she must have got filming that on that day?
I've no money and no prospect. I'm already a burden to my parents, and I'm frightened.
And that's the reality of that you were living in back in those days. This entire movie looks absolutely stunning. Every frame, every shot is beautiful. You cannot tell me otherwise. Twilight Who, am I right?
Any young lady would be happy to be the mistress of such a house.
I swear, he just enjoys talking to himself.
Oh, Lizzie, it's such a pleasure to run my own home.
I like how they went from Elizabeth literally judging her for marrying him to them just having tea and all that. They were so petty back then, but then they would just get over it like that.
Do not make yourself uneasy, my dear cousin, about your apparel.
I really wasn't that concerned about it until you actually mentioned it.
So you are Elizabeth Bennet?
I am, your ladyship.
Hmm.
You know it's never good when they go, so you're that person.
£300.
The hell are you doing here?
I'm a guest here.
You know my nephew.
Extensively.
Mr. Collins, you can't sit next to your wife. Move. Over there.
Well, this isn't going to cause any sort of tension in the room now, is it?
I haven't been fortunate enough.
You play the pianoforte, Miss Bennet?
A little, ma'am, and very poorly.
I'm sorry, is this an interview or are we just having casual dinner conversation?
Has your governess left you?
We never had a governess.
No governess.
Are you just absolutely dirt poor?
Your mother must have been quite a slave to your education.
Not at all, Lady Catherine.
She just can't help herself.
I am well enough acquainted with you, Miss Elizabeth, to know that I cannot alarm you even should I wish it.
Oh, they're such a flirt. And I love it!
I do not have the talent of conversing easily with people I have never met before.
Perhaps you should take your aunt's advice and practice.
You want to put a little salt in that wound there?
Please do be seated.
Don't got time for that.
I believe my aunt did a great deal to it when Mr. Collins first arrived.
I believe so.
Is there anything else you want to say other than barging into my place of note writing?
Good day, Miss Elizabeth. It's been a pleasure.
What? You gonna tease me like that and then just walk off the hell?
Flying, which we cannot procure for ourselves.
She's like, oh, mother of God, what have I gotten myself into? Lord, help me, baby Jesus.
He saved the man from an imprudent marriage.
Who was the man?
Oh no.
There were apparently strong objections to the lady.
What kind of objection?
I think it was a family that was considered unsuitable.
Alright, Darcy, you're about to get slapped. Of course. Of course you're here.
To end my agony.
I don't understand.
I love you.
Oh.
Most ardently.
After you make sure that my sister gets broken up with, you have some nerve.
And my sister, to its derision for disappointed hopes.
You got something to say there, bruh?
The acutest kind.
I do not deny it.
Uh-huh.
I did it for his own good.
My sister hardly shows her true feelings to me.
He's like, well, okay, I may have f***ed up, but...
It was the lack of propriety shown by your mother, your three younger sisters, even on occasion your father.
They really had to insert that lightning bolt right there, didn't they?
Mr. Wickham.
I love the way he says that name.
Fences might have been overlooked had not your pride been hurt by my honest.
Do you not remember the name of the movie? It's Pride and Prejudice, baby!
That you were the last man in the world I could ever be prevailed upon to marry.
Oh, is that right? Yeah, give it an hour.
Forgive me, madam, for taking up so much of your time.
She is this close to drop dead kissing that boy right on the lips. Do you really think about it? This movie comes down to warfare. These two, Pride, Prejudice, Rock, Hard Place, they don't want to give their way. They want to see who is going to give up first. It's almost like the anime Kaguya-sama Love is War was based off this.
Looking in the mirror all the time.
Slipping through my fingers all the time.
As to the other matter, that of your sister.
I get goosebumps of this every single time I watch it.
Are you all right?
I hardly know.
No, she's not. And neither are we!
She owes me a lot!
She probably can't afford
it. Some better company.
What's happening? That musical theme gets me every single time. My mother even, when I was a kid, she learned the entire music to this whole movie. And she was really, really talented. And she played it beautifully. Imagine this being your home. You walk downstairs, you're like, huh, well, did I just walk into the Met Gala? That's totally, totally inaccurate. Where are the sideburns? Oh, the zoom in right there. That's just, it's too good. She's like, okay, I didn't mean to see that. Let me out of here.
May I see you back to the village?
No, very fond of walking.
Yes.
And I swear, if you try to walk with me right now, I will confess my love to you. So no, we cannot do that.
Goodbye, Mr. Darcy.
This is pain.
How did he beat us?
He particularly wants you to meet his sister.
I am slipping farther and farther away into love.
Then he has perjured himself most profoundly.
No, I said.
Wait a second. Are you smiling? Cause I'm pretty sure hell is still burning down there. Oh, I forgot what happens here. What happens?
Lydia has run away with Mr. Wickham.
Oh, that's right. That's right.
But I know very well that nothing can be done. We have not the smallest hope.
And Darcy said, okay, well, hold my sideburn.
I will join Mr. Bennet and find Lydia before she ruins the family forever.
Would that really ruin the whole family, though? I hate to be dark, but you know what I mean?
Father will settle £100 a year on her. That is Wickham's condition.
So I agree.
£100 a year? How much is that? I always get fascinated by the, like, inflation stuff. I want to hear what that is.
You're married.
How quick the tables turn, isn't it? and there you are, you sneaky, greasy little
I hope you have half my good luck, Lydia.
You know, if Lydia kind of got hit over the head with a frying pan, I wouldn't be that mad.
I don't like Mr. Darcy. Oh, I forgot, but I shouldn't have said a word.
Oh, that's right, Mr. Darcy is the one. Mr. Darcy's the one who did it.
Mr. Darcy's not half as high mighty as he is sometimes.
Mr. Darcy actually happens to turn out to be a really good guy, just a very stubborn little
Kitty? Have you seen my ring?
See, this is why I love rewatching this, because I've forgotten a lot of the twists and the turns. I didn't appreciate them as much when I was a kid.
But then I had nothing else to do.
Oh, I'm sorry, are we recording?
We shan't mention a word about it. Is it quite certain he's coming?
You literally just said, we don't care about him at all. Now, are you positive that he's coming? Well, you thought your mother was stressed out before. Oh, wait till now.
Mr. Bingley! Mr. Bingley? Oh my goodness!
It's f***ing going down!
Everybody stay calm!
What's the procedure?
Stay f***ing calm!
How you two doing?
There've been a great many changes since you went away. Miss Lucas is married.
First thing you say is marriage and settled. Really, really.
My Jane looks well. Does she not?
Mom, you laid it on a little bit thick.
Darcy's like, I'm going to wring that little neck out. Just imagine you're having this conversation about how to propose to somebody and your literal backdrop is a painting.
I've been so blind. What do you mean?
You know what she means.
But I would like to request the privilege of speaking to Miss Bennet.
I accept you, Jane, dear. Of course.
Mr. Bingley, I wanted to let you know again that she still has nothing on her finger.
I must tell you, I've been the most unmitigated and comprehensive ass.
Yes. Yes, you have.
Yes.
Ah, you love to see it. This movie always gets to me.
Thank the Lord for that. I thought it would never happen.
Y'all couldn't wait until we at least come out? Are you serious? Let's think of all the things he's done. He found Lydia. He paid his childhood hatred. And he got these two together now. Kiss me, kiss me, kiss me. Or do me. Whichever one you want to do.
Unfathomable. No doubt poisoned by his pernicious sister. Bravo.
Yeah, that sister can go get it in hell.
Oh, Lizzie, if I could but see you so happy, if there was such another man for you.
Oh, but there is.
Lady Catherine.
What?
I need to speak to Miss Elizabeth Bennet alone, as a matter of urgency.
Well, I mean, I normally don't swing that way, but okay.
Now what have you to say?
Only this, if that is the case, you can have no reason to suppose he would make an offer to me.
Oh,
now tell me once and for all, are you engaged to him?
She's not engaged, but is there grounds? Hell yes.
I must ask you to leave immediately.
Suck on that, Grandma!
Y'all need to let me know in the comments, where in the world did they film this? I want to go visit this. Like, some people want to go visit where the Lord of the Rings were filmed. I want to go see where this was filmed. Literally has the white puffy shirt walking out of the mist with the trail coat behind him. Good Lord, go over to it.
If your feelings are still what they were last April, tell me so at once. But one word from you will silence me forever.
What do you do if you hear someone say that? You say, get over here, big boy.
You have bewitched me, body and soul, and I love you. Love.
Bewitched me, body and soul. What a line. Should I use that to propose to my wife? And the sunset comes through. Are you kidding me? Like, put this on the poster.
Lizzie, are you out of your senses? I thought you hated the man.
Hate, love, same thing.
I love him.
It makes me so happy. Oh, this movie.
How if I told you what he was really like, what he's done?
What has he done?
Well, I mean, I'm gonna have to write down a list, but if you want, I can show you.
He's been a fool about so many other things, but then so have I.
That's the thing to every relationship. There's ups and there's downs on both sides.
He and I are so similar.
Shockingly so. Look what you're doing to him and me!
I would not have parted with you, my Lizzie, to anyone less worthy.
Best father-daughter relationship of all time. You can't tell me otherwise.
Father always calls my mother when he's cross about something.
What endearments am I allowed?
Imagine if you talked like this all the time, this matter of speech. How do you always just keep everything so nonsensical, you know?
You may only call me Mrs. Darcy when you are completely, perfectly, and incandescently happy.
There's gonna be a lot of Mrs. Darcy's around here.
Mrs. Darcy.
If he had said that to me, I would have been like, all right, well, I guess we're trying something new today. All right, so that was Pride and Prejudice from 2005, starring Keira Knightley. I love that movie to death. I love the memories that it holds for me and my mother, and it still very easily holds up to today's standards. I love all the performances, all the nuances, all the twists and turns, the music, especially the scenery, the composition. That is the definition of filmmaking, and I'm so glad I got to watch it with you all today. But if you you like what you saw here today and you want to see more, if you could go ahead and hit that subscribe button and that like button, I would truly appreciate it. It really does help me out so much. Also, follow me at the two social medias, Twitter, Instagram, both on time. So don't forget to check out my Twitch at twitch.tv/moviesindepth, where we stream every single time a new video goes live at 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Go ahead, check out the page, and maybe even subscribe if you're feeling frisky. Also, don't forget to check out my Discord community at Movies in Depth, where you can hang out with me and the rest of the Movies in Depth family. And don't forget to check out my Patreon at patreon.com/moviesindepth for the full uncut linked reaction to this and all other movies and TV shows covered on the channel as well, including exclusive Patreon content like You Season 3, Firefly, Supernatural, tons of movies. It's a good time. Head on over there. And besides all that, I'll Pride and Prejudice you all in another one.